Hey, you.
Ask Neil Patrick Harris to describe his role on A Series of Unfortunate Events, and you might just get this.
There's lots of different weird isms.
Beautiful, no?
He plays Count Olaf, a disguise-wearing villain bent on robbing three orphans of their inheritance. Based on the Lemony Snicket books, the dark comedy is binge-watchable for adults and kids.
How have your choices changed at all since you became a father yourself?
Having kids just gives me a different perspective of how they process information. So I'm less myopic. I think I try to be more aware that content can have more than one audience. I think it's important for people to be able to watch stuff together.
For sure.
And I probably didn't have that perspective when I was childless.
One of the things I think is really interesting about your career is that I feel like you can tell how old a person is based on if you say Neil Patrick Harris, what their response is. Really, right? Because
yeah,
it would
enough.
The initial, like, oh, Doogie Howser.
Sure.
Oh, How I Met Your Mother.
Sure.
And now, oh, Series of Unfortunate Events.
That's
which is
kind of great.
It's kind of a great way to look at your own career, right? That means that you've done so much for so long for so many people.
I've had multiple chapters, and I'm hopeful that it's a healthy encyclopedia of books.
That's Count Olaf in disguise. He's in the middle of a scheme to steal our fortune.
What sane man would disguise himself four times in a row?
You obviously have lots of different get-ups, but I think that as Count Olaf, the most interesting changes that happen are on your face. Do you practice this stuff in the mirror at home?
Not at home. I was actually surprised when I watched season one that it wasn't more over the top. And I think because I'm wearing prosthetics, which is actual latex, which is glued to my actual face, if I just want to do a quizzical brow, I kind of have to do it harder. And if I want to do a really big one, like you really have to commit to facial expressions. So I've gotten quite good at how my face moves.
Look for new moves, new storylines, and new guest stars in season two of a great show about some truly terrible people.
It's really going to be quite dreadful. I can't wait.